YouTube is picking up. YouTube should be live. Looks good and sounds good there. So we are live and on the air with the person typing on their extremely loud keyboard.
Don't know who that would be.
So we are live and on the air, and welcome to the Foolish Tech Show. It is Friday, TGIF. We are here mainly to provide you with support and answer any questions about our products and services. If you have any of those, always feel free to jump over to our IRC chat with the many options we have at foolishtechshow.com or foolishit.com/live. And yes, we do include a bunch of news, as Phoenix has pointed out in our chat there. And that's probably what we're going to end up focusing on today. I don't think we have any demos ready. I know, Phoenix, I told you I was going to show you that thing going against Holy Crypt, but I apparently broke something significantly, so it's not doing its job at all now. So gonna have to look a little bit more into that, but I did get some email notifications and whatchamacallit. Jay Chamberlain broke D7-2 again. What do you got this time? And Glenn, what do you got on the Windows 8 and 10 auto login stuff? When the user is used log on as other user. Yeah, the Windows 8 and 10, it acts very weird. So It should, I believe 8 should do the domain. I didn't get a chance to test that side, but 10, it should just be like a normal user account, even if it is a Microsoft or not.
Jerk.
No one did.
Who did that? Someone muted me. Who's master of this domain?
I'm Johnny.
I don't know.
I am.
You mean
and I did not mute you.
Okay.
Oh, I found that program, by the way. It's called NoSpeak. That's what you had made for.
NoSpeak. Thank you. I lost the code for that, I guess.
I think I have the code for that as well.
What the heck did that do? I don't mute you, but I.
I want to say it was either it gave you keywords. It was, I believe it was a keyboard shortcut and
mute yourself.
Yeah, and it also showed indicated your status. So that told
your muted status, right. Okay.
Right.
Yeah, well that wouldn't do anything for me being muted on the show though, because it's a system thing. Now I went to mute myself to hit this and I was already muted. And I was like, wait a minute. Is that because I said that thing and Twitch was already live?
Anyway, Jay Chamberlain's, if you're doing everything in the auto session, the start session, I don't think there's going to be a way to tell you when the job's complete, or you're talking about when it sends out after, when you end the session. That's probably the one you're talking about. If that's the case, checking the email settings on it. Yay, you're doing it your way. That's the best way.
Was that Sinatra way?
Awesome. So, So I noticed you weren't using the dCloud SMTP server, which we don't recommend because that's not as reliable, because if everyone was using that, we'd have tons of issues and it can easily get blacklisted and us not know about it. But yeah, the email stuff shouldn't be too bad. I'm pretty sure you're using a self-hosted email, so it shouldn't have anything to do with a Google account or Office 365. Those have some quirks when sending email with the methods that are being used. But yeah, it shouldn't have any issues there. All that relies upon is going to be the email settings in your config server setup, and or making sure that box is checked when you have on the in session and or you're doing the email notification like we talked about. I'm gonna fire one up real quick and double check here. So there shouldn't be anywhere else that you would have to look. Yeah, the mini is still definitely the best way to go. And like we had talked about it, and I'm assuming your way means that it starts up and then the user does the start auto mode is the recommended course of action. So I'm booting up a system for that. Glenn, okay, so you're saying that when it shows up as other user when they're logging in under a MS account. I didn't notice that in my testing on Windows 10, but maybe I wasn't looking. I'm assuming you mean when it gives you the list of users at the login screen, it shows up as other user there. And that is very possible. And it kind of automatically works around the whole if they're using a PIN code kind of thing. So I believe that's actually how Microsoft wanted to do it, but I'm not positive on that. So oh dang it, I restored the wrong one. Of course I did. All right, now I should be able to check on your email thing. Just make sure here. But Glenn, does it still auto log in even if it's showing up as other user? Because I noticed when I did put things in incorrectly, it would come up as that other user, I believe. I'm not positive. Windows 10 and 8 just messed up things so badly for login stuff like that. Oh, cool. Rover Desk set up a D-Link DSN-321. Oh, that's a great product name. After having not used it for 3 years and now has a mini web server on it. That's cool. So Glenn, I don't know if you watched the show yesterday where we tried to do those, and Windows 10 did give me the most trouble with it even after I'd done some testing prior in the day. But it should be that the user appears as a shortened username, possibly if it's a long username for the Microsoft account. But if it you should be able to select it out of the list and then just put their password in, and it should log in correctly and as expected. If it's a Microsoft account, you have to treat it like it's a domain, so it's not going to be able to change the password on there. So you would want to make sure you get the correct one to have it logged in. But past that, it should be working for you. Oh, Riverdesk was looking for that DOS CAD program. Christopher got a HTC Vive and he just messaged me that he played a boxing game and he can feel the burn this morning.
So Dave and Buster's, they have this boxing game that I used to play. I don't know if this is the case, but I used to love Dave and Buster's when I used to live near them. Don't really anymore. But they used to have this game where you basically got up there and...
Who and what? What are you talking about?
Boxing. And
still trying to figure out what HTC Vive is. You're talking about Dave and Buster's. Who the hell is that?
It's a place where you go to play video games and eat and drink.
Oh, well, thank you for elaborating for everyone who's never been to a small little hole-in-the-wall arcade. Why don't you say an arcade?
No, it's not an arcade.
Chain, and it's not just
a Chuck E. Cheese is then, whatever you're talking about. You said
eat. It is the adult version of Chuck E. Cheese. I'll give you that. It's the adult version of Chuck E. Cheese.
Anyway, it's the one place you can go and safely.
Is that a VR thing, Brantley, HTC Vive? Is that?
Yes. It is. It's the main two competitors out there, Oculus Rift and HTC Vive. HTC Vive comes with two little controllers that you hold. Oculus Rift, I believe you get gloves. So
I found that the Wii was pretty awesome with boxing.
The Wii was
one of those guys. Pretty good.
We had boxing.
Yeah, Wyatt's been playing my guy for a long time, and he's like, every time I play, it goes down and down your score.
All right, cool, Glenn. Let us know what you find out about that, because like I said, that Windows 10 was really difficult to figure out how it was all exactly working and correctly. And I didn't do the best setup because I added a Microsoft account afterwards, and then we tried going it, but yeah. That was me, and I was the one that got the chip in, Fool 43626. Johnny and I actually went to tour camp this year, and yeah, I was wearing my
on the mother. What?
I was wearing the D72 shirt.
Oh, awesome!
Getting it. So that was. Do you have a link to that video? Because I would like to see that actually.
Yeah, double.
So Jay Chamberlain, everything I confirmed is under the config. server/email SMTP server email options. As long as you have the use manual SMTP settings on the page, radio button selected, you have your server name, your username, which you may have to use as the full email address. That would be a possibility of some issues there, but then making sure you have the right encryption and port and password, and probably checking the authentication box. Those are your big things there. And that send test email button should let you know when you do get it right. So, and yeah, awesome. Thanks, Fool 43626. That'd be awesome. I'd love to see that video. That it was a really fun conference. I did really enjoy it. So, I was watching our friend Door-to-Door Geek on the Podnuts Network with Android App Addicts last night, and he pointed out an insanely crazy link that I was super impressed with. Apparently, Crossover, who is a company that makes wine stuff work on other stuff, they are apparently going to bring Windows apps to Android via Wine. So they're going to have a customized version of Wine and you're going to be able to run Windows executables on your Android phone. How crazy is that?
Wow.
And that basically opens it up for Chromebook as well, because it's fairly similar and they're kind of merging those two anyway. So that's, I think that's going to be crazy. Duer did mention that one thing it does is it opens up your Android device to a ton of malware and malicious software, but it'll be a little bit more sandboxed, so that's a good thing. Past that, it was just released into a private beta yesterday, I believe, and it's going to start going forward, so probably it's got a little bit of time before you start running Office 365 on your Android phone, but someday, maybe, someday. Ah, and Jay Chamberlain got the email thing working. Cool. Yeah, Phoenix, he is a pretty interesting character. I'll say that much. I really enjoy him. The first time I met him was at OLF, Ohio Linux Festival with Johnny. Good times, good times. Sweet, man. Now I really want to watch this video, but it's 11 minutes long.
I'm watching it for you. Don't worry.
Okay. Awesome. Get us the relevant links.
Link us to the direct time.
All right, I will.
Yeah.
Still there. Yeah, Jeff's a pretty cool guy as well. So we got the crossover thing. That was cool. Let's look over some of Phoenix's links here, because he did post a bunch of stuff that some of them were pretty interesting. Don't really care about mega upload domains being FBI controlled and doing soft porn. That's better than the child porn site they ran for 2 weeks last year.
Glad you pointed that out, by the way, because I was thinking the same thing.
Yeah. The top men behind Kick-Ass Torrents? Maybe. We'll wait for the court stuff to come out on that.
That stuff is just not terribly interesting, I don't think, to our community.
I did like the open source 25 core processor.
That was awesome.
Up to 200,000 cores. So
that is awesome. Actually, it's interesting that they only mentioned 200,000 cores in that, because theoretically, if you look at the design, it's supposed to go to a 500 million cores. So I don't know where they just started to harp on the 200,000 figure, but interestingly enough, it's not. They sometimes call it the biggest educational processor, open source processor, but it's actually not. But it is an interesting design, and I think it's designed for data center use. And so I think that probably has potential lower costs for data centers, and replace a lot of potentially could displace some Intel or AMD hardware. I don't know. It's.
I totally did not realize that was the motherboard guy. Man, I should know my stuff better. I was a little bit out of it at Tor Camp though. So, anyway, I keep going back to it. Anyway, let's see. There was some other good stuff in here. The GoDaddy users hit by a clever phishing scam. Phoenix, I'm hoping maybe you read that article and tell us what that clever phishing scam was. Patching the Cisco firewall thing against the NSA leaked exploits. I wonder if they patched the updated version that came out that you linked to earlier in the week. That would be interesting to find out they didn't. But not so much on that. Information commissioner to investigate data sharing between WhatsApp and Facebook. Get over it. You're using a Facebook-controlled company. Get over it. If you don't like the idea of Facebook having your info, don't use their company's stuff.
No.
I'd seen this thing about what to do if Chrome isn't allowing you to view Microsoft sites. And I haven't had that issue yet, but I was fairly interested in the way that you can easily remove cookies for that specific site. I thought that was pretty interesting. Apparently, if you go through the lock icon or the HTTP icon.
You never noticed that before?
I haven't had a need to, but I did think it was cool.
Cookies
for a specific site. Apparently a lot of people didn't know that before.
I think that was in the first Chrome ever. Or something. I've been using Chrome, yeah.
Huh. Yeah, never knew about it.
A long time, anyway.
I don't really have that big issues with cookies, and if I do have any issues that may be related to cookies, I just wipe my internet history cache anyway. So.
Oh, you don't work on our website enough, then.
That's true. That's very true. I do not do that. At least not any of the parts that have to deal with our cookies.
Like everything when you're logged in and you don't want to be or whatever.
I'm going to skip the Windows 10 anniversary update causing issues news because even if it is common hardware causing problems. I don't really care about the device assistant on there. Keeping big data secure. I don't think anybody here does big data stuff, or if they do, I hope they know how to keep it secure already. Russia's Google equivalent is building self-driving shuttle. And no one cares about Spotify and punishing artists. I don't think that's very relevant. More interesting. I did like this one though. Option to add OTP with your YubiKey to Ubuntu for sudo or login. That's pretty cool. I will have to look into that one. Thanks for that.
So I'm about breaking PowerShell.
What broke? What? Where? Oh, I haven't gotten down to that yet, so hold on. We know how to import and export passwords, and haven't got that.
Use PowerShell, though.
Apparently, I posted your 10 seconds of fame.
Yay!
Cheers.
Oh, yes.
Did they include any of my fun quirkiness?
They included you getting injected, yeah.
That's it? They didn't ask me? Oh, they asked me all those questions and post that?
Yeah.
Okay. I knew that guy looked familiar.
D7X!
Yeah. I did score! That's so awesome. I so did not realize that was another... I probably saw a whole bunch of people that are really internet famous and I just...
Is Glenn here?
Did not even know.
Is Glenn here? Yes,
Glenn is here. Why don't you just look at the chat?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's here. Oh, geez. This is just... you know what? I don't even need to go here. Forget it. This is just an Australian story. Forget it.
Cool.
It's not worth it.
Awesome. He forgot it. Let's go. Let's move on.
Yeah. Hey, Glenn, check out the... yesterday's show, I don't even think I mentioned it, but towards the end of the show, we had talked about the number six problem or the legend of question six, I believe it was. That was actually for the Australian Mathlympics. So I thought you would think that was interesting. And I want to see this 10 seconds of fame here, real quick.
It's Australian for Mathlympics.
Better than 11 minutes. Yeah, that first guy was, he was right ready for it.
Nothing. He doesn't use it for anything.
Sweet. They didn't use the, what do I use my implant for? Yeah, that's right. I was like, right when I told them, they were like, no, they said, yeah, that too. They said, when I was done with it, they were like, so what are you getting this for? And the other guy was like, oh, so I can unlock my phone or I can blah, blah, blah. And I was like, cause it's free. They apparently weren't impressed with that.
I got mine the next day. No idea why. When they were recording.
Yeah. So, Fool 43626, no, it cannot run D7 automatically. But I was actually talking with Dor about it last night, and he told me about a trick that people used to do where they would take apart their keyboard and put a NFC receiver in there. And then you just wave your hand over your keyboard and it like logs you in or does some special tricks or something. I was thinking about doing that. That actually does sound pretty cool. Or even like have it so it's in my mouse. So when I'm using my mouse, my computer just automatically unlocks, which usually I have to move my mouse to bring my computer back from monitors off and stuff. So that would be pretty sweet. We may look into running D7.2 automatically with it. It'll probably be D7X. But cool. Thank you for that link. That's very awesome. I'd been wondering where that video ended up getting posted.
Phoenix, we can't lose our chips.
Yeah, you can lose your...
Something has to be said about that, though, and that would be the biggest point, I think, to push what Brantley did. I, having had a two-factor chip, I lost mine, and that could have been horrible had
I... lost your Christmas present?
I remember he threw
it away with the napkins on his table.
Yeah. So, at any rate...
Not really losing. That's being a dumbass.
Yeah.
It's a Friday. I'm sorry.
But it is a concern, and you know why they had to make the damn thing so tiny is another issue. But
it blows my mind because you had the same napkin on your coffee table for like 2 years every time I went to your house.
I know, but this wasn't on my coffee table; it was on my computer desk, and I thought it was increasing my productivity by cleaning up my workspace. So
plus, it also has a keyring hole, so it goes on your keyring.
I was concerned I would break it in the key ring because my keys go through a lot of shit.
And all oh my goodness, there. I've lost mine. Oh, wait, here it is. It's on the key ring.
I wish I had put it on a key ring. That was my mistake. I should have done that immediately. But it just to point out, though, that I'm sure other people are a little bit silly like me. And have.
Now, if it was a YubiKey, I might get that implant. Uh-oh.
That's a pretty big implant. Uh-oh. That's not
good. And,
I think I left that at the pool. Okay.
Well, that one of the big things about the YubiKeys is they do highly recommend that you get more than one. So, you should have a backup of them anyway. And if you use
You'll never
them
hear.
For separate purposes, then you would want to, get three. You want to have one that's stored away that's in a safe location you can access if needed if you lose your other ones. Chrome has support for YubiKey, the U2F feature of it. Firefox is working on it, and a few websites like Google, Dropbox, and GitHub have the U2F, but that is not the main feature of YubiKeys. They also do static passwords, OTP, cloud OTP, and NFC storage. So like mine's actually replaced Google Authenticator for mine because I don't have to have my phone with it specifically set up that I end up wiping and then having to go through and reset up all my stuff. With the YubiKey storing all those, I can just have it on the YubiKey and use it. So Yeah, my implant is definitely not going anywhere. Johnny's might get into her bloodstream and fly away.
She was
super scared. So, like, Johnny, of course, didn't listen to him and said, don't touch it, don't play with it, don't do anything until it's had about 2 weeks to really grasp into your skin and meld there. And the first night, Johnny's like, oh my gosh. And I was like, what? And she's like, it fell down. I was like, what? She's like,
it moved.
It was up here and now it's moved down here. And I was like, well, quit playing with it. And she was like, oh my gosh, this is bad. What's going to happen? I was like, well, it's probably going to get into your bloodstream. And then you're going to have to unlock your phone in like weird ways, like finding where. Right here. Get it. Oh, come on. And she freaked out about it. Ended up emailing support, and then we ended up going talking to the guy, and then the guy immediately left camp right after that so that he wouldn't have to deal with her anymore. But
nah, that's not why.
It was fun though.
Cheers.
And I don't like saying Google, GitHub, Gmail all support YubiKeys. I prefer to say U2F, because that's the specific thing that those are supporting past it. I mean, I use the U2F plus the static password, and I use the OTP in other situations. So it has several features. And like I said, I use the Google Authenticator style passwords as well. So with the Neo, you can get 4 different security additions to your arsenal, so it's pretty cool. And yeah, that page does explain all of those options, actually, so except the static password, which I really don't understand why that's not bigger used password feature. That's a pretty sweet feature. Mm-hmm. Your passwords instantly become 32 characters long, and you can add stuff to it, so cool stuff there. So I did have a couple interesting ransomware things to talk about here, and has given me some things to put into CryptoPrevent. This one is a Venus Locker. It's a .NET ransomware. And the main thing I wanted to point out on this one is it actually creates a 0-byte file in your user home directory to indicate if it's already encrypted things or not. So, guess what CryptoPrevent is going to start doing? Creating a 0-byte file so that it thinks it's already encrypted them. That's going to actually be a pretty easy one. I thought that was pretty interesting.
CD dot caret file name.
It's like, it's
what's this thing? What is it? Echo dot. No, the greater than. I'm sorry. Never mind. Go ahead. Thank you, Beavis. I'm just sneezing. Discombobulated me.
So yeah, that's a pretty easy way to prevent that from happening. So I thought that was cool, and thanks Malwarebytes for breaking down that ransomware for us. This was another interesting one, which I was going to have to talk more with Nick about, and we probably want to do it off air for security reasons so they don't figure out how to stop us from...
Probably, and also I've got the sneezes.
So Locky and Zepto ransomware can now be installed from a DLL, so it's going to be hard to block run dll32.exe from injecting DLLs, so we're going to have to talk more about how we may be able to assist in that preventative measure. And then another update on ransomware is there is a new torrent locker, and it has a... it encrypts files with the .enc extension. So if you get that one, then you know you got that new version, and you may be out of luck for the moment on actually recovering from that one. So just throwing that out there for people. John or Nick, I did want to ask you about how you thought this compared to ETS, or if it even is a comparison. But GHAX had a review on a program, and it was a couple weeks ago. But it was a run program. It's called Power Run. Run programs.
Is trusted. Wasting my time with this right now.
I just wanted to know.
You know, I'm trying to compile the next. Never mind.
No, I didn't. So, anyway, well, I guess never mind then.
Trusted installer.
No. It's wasting your time. Don't look at it.
Just kidding.
While he looks at that, though, Jay Chamberlain, there are ways to decrypt some of the ransomware. Some of them have their servers confiscated, like a recent one happened in Dutchland. Poland or Dutch, one of those. They confiscated a server and got all the encryption keys and released a decryption tool for it. There are a few other ones that have had similar things, or people have broken it down. Like,
if you could let me know which one specifically, I can tell you if there's a decryptor for it. I have a lot.
What's the name of that site? I think he was just asking in general. But what's the name of that site that identifies what you've been encrypted with and tells you?
Let me find it. Let me pull it. We have an article on that. Let me pull it. There we go. And
it doesn't seem right.
Yeah, it's called ID. Here's the link. I'll paste the link in there in the chat, Brantley. There it is.
Yeah, so that one will help you identify it and also give you options on possible ways to get it. It's hard to be in a general sense with that because they have so many variations. I think I've had Michael researching ransomware this whole past 2 weeks almost.
Yeah.
And what was the one you said you saw, like a few hundred variations of it?
Yeah, the EDA2, the educational one. In fact, that Venus Locker you're talking about is a variant of that, and I had already analyzed that. The one thing I didn't pick out, the fact is, I noted that file being there, but I didn't note that that it won't encrypt if that's there. So thank you for bringing that to my attention. I updated the information there to point to it. But that's the one that there's so many variants of, and you'll continue to see it. And they're tacking on, like I said the other day, they're tacking on a ton of stuff to it. They're making them a lot more advanced than what the initial educational thing was. So
yeah. So it's hard to be generalized with those, but sites like that will help you track down which one you have specifically and then be able to point you in some more directions if you can decrypt it.
Doesn't help that sometimes ransomware is identified by two different places as two different things, you know? That's the naming schemes with ransomware. They've been so, so many variants have come out. Sometimes you don't always, you read two different write-ups about two seemingly different ransomwares, and there it turns out they're the same thing. It's interesting. Yeah.
So
it's been like the same thing for as long as I can remember. How was that interesting?
So, Slick Will, there have been versions of CryptoLocker and other links. I want to say some of the CryptoWall's early ones were decryptable and things like that. And then you do have other sites that link to places like that. If you want to post some of those links you have for sites for decrypting in there, that would be awesome.
Please. You want to share that info.
We're always happy to learn more.
That's the hidden tier decryptor. I'm going to go through. I'll post. No, it's usually individual researchers that are putting out these decryptors, and so they're not have big host. They don't have usually have big hosted sites. Let me see if I can do it faster.
And wildfires completely open now. They just saw a post about that.
Here is a Cerber decryptor.
Is that one going to work for the newer variants, though, too?
Not always. Some of these decryptors only work with the earlier variants, but sometimes they're updated. So good to give it a shot. Le Chiffre has been decrypted, and there's a couple of ones. Both MCSoft and McAfee have ones on that. And here's another one. That's that French one.
I like how he said that. That's the French one.
Crypto Locker has a ton of ones to decrypt it. Those are all old though.
Phoenix server ransomware is actually a fairly interesting one. Michael was pointing out to me that they're the ones that they actually change the hash of the payload file like every 15 seconds, 15 minutes?
Mm-hmm. It's 15 seconds.
Yeah, so it's almost impossible to hash block that one. So
there's crypto host can be decrypted too. It's actually the easiest one to decrypt. So you have to look at the file name, but basically they give you the key in the file name, which is crazy.
Nice. It'd be fun to see like a ransomware that just renames things. It doesn't actually encrypt anything. Maybe it inserts a whole bunch of text at the beginning if it sees it's a text document, so it looks encrypted when they try to open it.
Here's one for Locker or Locker-like ones. Now, just be careful on the Locker ones. There's a lot of variety of these, and it may or may not be the one you're actually infected with, so keep that in mind.
All right. Well, we don't need a whole bunch of those links. I was more looking for if Slickwill had some good ones to add in to the ones that we already have there. So.
Okay. Cool.
He points to the Kaspersky one. They have been doing a lot of good unlocking on ransomware. So.
Oh, this Blood Dolly guy does great jobs, by the way, with his decryptors. He's done probably the most decryptors that I've seen. He's a good researcher.
Cool.
And there's one for, okay, I'll stop posting, but there's one for Jigsaw. There's one for Chimera. There's one for CryptXXX. There's one for ODC with that. That's the extension. There's one for Bart. There's one for Stampato. And there's one for Unlock 92. And there's one for Zorist, XORIST. If any of these are ringing a bell
out there, so that's I would suggest starting with that ID site and then going from there, and a pretty easy Google search from there should get you in going. My headset battery is about to die, so I gotta switch out real quick, but I did want to post this link because this actually has been happening to me, and I thought it was just because I had a whole bunch of stuff in my download folder. But apparently Windows 10, the download folder, they decided to optimize this folder for pictures. So if you've ever gone into your downloads folder on Windows 10 and it's taken a while to load, it's because it's trying to do and render pictures. If you change that option to general items,
yeah, it loads straight away. I've done that a lot. That definitely was something that pissed me off initially.
Yeah, and I had been actually just taking, like, if you don't have a bunch of stuff in there, or I guess no pictures at all, it displays immediately. But if you have a bunch of stuff in there, it takes forever to go through. So, all right, somebody else take over because I gotta switch my battery real quick.
Oh gosh, Michael, don't think that's you. Proctor, what you got?
I saw that coming a mile away.
I know, man. God, I was like, ah, no! They're all gonna laugh at you! Adam Sandler. Beavis, well, you gotta be Beavis on the show to run the show.
He asked Beavis if he could come on sometime.
Did he really?
Yeah.
When?
No, last
it should be a Friday. It should probably be a Friday. No, he's no. No, because we were asking him, and he was like, "No, he came up with every excuse in the world." He was like, "I haven't taken a shower today." I was like, well, "You don't have to even be on video."
I thought that conversation started with him asking when we were going to invite him on the show.
It did, but he was then he was backing
he
out of
down,
it.
Yeah.
So I thought this was an interesting article, although it doesn't have a bunch of new information that we didn't already know, but apparently up to 90% of people ignore security warnings and alerts 90% of the time based on this study. Hopefully this study wasn't using Excel because that apparently also has caused numerous errors.
Oh, my God. Yeah, did you see that in all the scientific papers of rounding error in Excel was the cause of like 20% of the papers that were published have these problems in it, and that means all their data is invalid.
Well, you can get like a little – like, see, you can – Beavis, you can just get like a little picture instead. You can do like a – you can call in, you know, or you can, you know, do something like this. I always like this one. This is one of my best. But, you know, do whatever you want. Just, yeah, we'll give you the links. Right, Proctor?
Yeah.
Yeah, they do here's, make more work for us.
For Beavis.
A good thing, I guess.
All right. Well, you've got a whole week. Just make let's make it next Friday, then. Friday's a good day for us.
He doesn't do Mondays or Tuesdays. He says it's too early. Wednesday.
It is too early for him. He's on the West Coast. And mostly the West Coast, anyway. Depending on the time of year, I guess. I don't know. They don't change their time. They're actually good about that.
Yeah, they don't care about daylight
it's
savings.
That's ridiculous. Right. Yeah, it's ridiculous that anyone else does. But just deal with it.
Preparation.
I did have...
Preparation what? H?
No, Beavis said was any hope for topics to prep for. I'm like, no, we don't know what prep is.
I know what prep H is. Got up close and personal to that lately.
All right.
Yeah. I did have one more ransomware that got away from me. Nothing particularly interesting except it fakes itself as KM Spico. But it was pretty interesting that it's the first one I've seen that includes ASCII art in its ransomware. So you get an ASCII art of a cow. So
maybe it'll make there's at least another one out there that does it. I've been reviewing ransom notes now for the same amount of time that you've mentioned, and there's a couple that use the ASCII art. A lot of ransom notes are actually just text files, so they don't have you know, the ability to display a lot of other stuff, except for ASCII as far as graphics. So, yeah. But it's cool, nonetheless.
Yeah. I thought this one would be a good one for Tank. Maybe he wants to try it out. Somebody tried to make a axe handle out of gummy bears. I just thought that was interesting. So.
I do not want to try that.
Come on, man. That's a great idea for your next camping trip. No worries about ants or bears or animals.
Yeah, none of them things.
Eating your axe handle. So apparently, if you couldn't already waste time enough on your computer, now there's an even easier way thanks to Google. Search for solitaire in Google and you'll be able to play solitaire in your browser. Thought that was fun. Too bad they can't.
Well, those people pissed at Microsoft taking away Solitaire from Windows 10 and, you know, or changing that around a little bit. But yeah.
So, Michael posted that right before me or after?
Yeah,
me?
It's weird. I must have been reading your mind. I did post that just a second before you did. Yeah.
I'm glad you read my mind, not me having to read yours. Keep your prep age.
Thank you, Beavis.
I hate the Unity launcher, Phoenix.
The Axeman just had to post that, didn't he?
I thought this was pretty cool.
Always an Axe character. Jesus.
Oh, and your...
Go on.
MMORPGs.
Yeah.
You
have my Axe! That was from Portal, was it? The show on G3? I'm just ruining it. I'm gonna mute.
I thought you were talking about Portal the game. I was like, where did they have an axe in that?
Yes, link for that one, Beavis. Thank you. I'll mute. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, you're fine, man.
I'm not.
Okay. You're not. Mute. I don't hate Linux. I hate Unity. And the newer Ubuntu versions really have turned me off on Ubuntu. I used to like it, but then they switched from GNOME, and man, it's not been any good since then to me. I like the Linux Mint. It actually does things better. I don't have to compile the NVIDIA driver myself, for example, so preferable.
You know, there's have you tried Ubuntu Mate or an alternative desktop for Ubuntu? Because there's Ubuntu distributions without Unity, I believe, if I'm not mistaken.
I know there are, but I want to go with the default, and I don't like their default. The Cinnamon version of Linux Mint works fairly well for me, so I prefer it. Anyway, what I've been trying to say for the past couple minutes is there is a place called Wikiverse, and it turns Wikipedia into a visual universe of articles. I thought that was pretty interesting. So if you want to waste a bunch of time, you can check that out. And as if it's not already easy enough to waste time on
the Foolish Tech Show.
Well, that too.
Oh yeah.
Here. If you really want to waste time, here is a website where you can move around blank boxes.
Ooh.
And you can resize them and move them around, and it has absolutely no point whatsoever. So, enjoy. Yeah, I like Mint. Why did we laugh out loud at Mint? Mint rocks. Fedora is a little bit more complex, so.
Oh, thank you, Beavis. No, I was just laughing because you were trying to say something.
Yeah, I know. I got you there.
No, I'm compiling that app that I was talking about like on Monday for the guy on the message forums that wanted all the URLs for the download URLs for stuff.
Oh.
For D72 apps and things that it uses so he can whitelist them as whatever. So I got an app that prints a list and I'll do domains only or full URLs. And I was just compiling that finally. Because I got started on it and I kept sidetracking on debug code and other things that I saw was wrong as I improved the debug code. And I kept sidetracking on all that. And then the more that I did, the more that I saw was wrong. So I kept sidetracking more and more and more. And it took a while. Was that last Monday or this?
I want to say it was last Monday because I don't remember it.
Okay, it's been a long sidetrack. But I'm compiling. I was just testing with the Obtu that I'm doing and compiling that right now. So... I'm gonna like actually hand that off to you in a little bit so you can release it, because I'm gonna go hang with Wyatt after the show.
Okay.
Cheers.
So there has been a second death directly related to Pokemon Go in Japan now.
Oh man.
Do not play Pokemon Go while you're driving, please.
Oh, just in driving.
Yeah.
That should be obvious.
In Japan. Hadn't there been like a couple of just like not driving?
No.
In the US or something? I thought there was.
Well, there was people getting mugged.
I know that. That was like all over the place, you know.
Yeah. I don't remember any deaths. There, one person found a dead body while they were playing.
I did see that article. She posted it on the show.
Yeah. They,
what was it? It was somebody falling off a cliff. Like, I heard about that. I didn't read that. How does that happen? Like, I understand, like, actually, no, I don't really understand the Google Maps thing if you're driving, but that's even worse when you're walking.
Yeah, and you fall off a cliff. That's crazy.
Are they really walking? Or?
Although, I did, like, almost twist my ankle today while mowing the lawn, just stepping off the curb. Which I didn't
realize. Were you trying to capture a Pokemon?
I was mowing the lawn, so I was walking back.
Trying to capture a Pokemon.
Just as bad.
There could have been one in there. Have you seen my grass? You have no idea. There could be like dozens in there, right there.
Yeah, yeah. I've caught a few at your house actually. That was when it first came out. Was when we went there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Looking for grass type Pokemon, head over to next place.
Is that a type of Pokemon?
Yeah, there's like grass fire types, air types.
Yeah, like Jade's Keaton came up to me and it was like this wood type, and I forget what the name of the thing was, but it meant fake, you know, and he was like a wood, and he was like earth and rock type or something. I don't know. It was a trick question. I was like, why are you screwing with me? Because I don't even know what the types are. And this is like the trick question of all Pokemon. And you're. Yeah, but thank you. Taking the time.
The legend of question Pokemon wood type. So I thought this was an interesting story. Apparently, some lady was trying to sell crickets on a train, a subway train in New York, and freaked out and then just started throwing crickets on everybody. So, terrible morning for those subway riders.
Crickets? That's not, it could be worse.
Like the phones?
Could have been.
No, like the actual animal insects.
Jeez.
Are you kidding me? Being trapped in a freaking subway car with a bunch of crickets everywhere? I'd be upset.
But the incessant chirping might die out the chatter from everyone else, which might be an improvement, a net benefit.
I doubt that it would, and you would also have them all freaking out as well.
Crickets, to me, wouldn't be the end of the world, though. I mean, if spiders or
you're on, like, your way to work or somewhere, and then all of a sudden this person throws crickets all over the train you're trying to get to work on.
It is New York City, okay? And it is the New York City subway. And if you've lived in New York City and been on the subway, you kind of expect shit to happen, you know? It's just a given. You're lucky. I mean, okay, there's times you don't go on the New York City subway because there's a lot of crimes that occur. Like, there's a couple of times a day that are like the crime rate in the subways is incredible, and it's weird. It's like early morning, and like another time, I don't know. You might have even told me that story.
It's funny he studies this.
But it's not the best place to
consider. I keep thinking of Dora the Explorer for some reason.
It's Michael.
Would you like to hear a story about domestication of rabbits in
Aztec? No, but you can sing the backpack song. Backpack, backpack, backpack. You don't know that song?
Your internet's dying.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think you may need a third
pound.
Oh, it says my internet connection is unstable.
Yeah. This one is for Glenn. Apparently, goldfish are turning into monsters in Australia.
Uh-oh. Oh, and I heard, okay, this was the story, Glenn, that I wanted to share with you. Not this one, actually, but about the submarines you guys bought, that the Indian submarines you guys bought, that the designs were all completely leaked or whatever. But anyway, what about the goldfish? That sounds crazy.
Read the article there. They're turning into monsters.
Yeah. Anyway, so it looks like there was some subs that were, I think, developed in India or whatever, and there was a leak giving out their data, and you know, India's trying to cover it up or whatever. But apparently, Australia invested their largest amount ever into defense spending when they went to get this submarine, and you know, if it's for the military, you know, you want those capabilities and things to be secret and defensive capabilities and whatnot. I thought that was a pretty big hit for them. Not leaking sub. I mean, not it doesn't leak, but it's all the information about its design has been exposed to effectively the public. Oh my God, that's a huge goldfish.
You're saying it. Yeah, it's going to sink, dude. Loose lips sink ships.
I think subs are supposed to sink. It's like their primary design, actually.
They're not supposed to be buoyant.
I kept trying. I was actually playing Battleship with Wyatt last week, and I kept going, "You sank my U-boat!" And he's like, "What?" So it's like trying to draw, you know?
I thought this was pretty interesting. So apparently scientists and others have a trigger set up to alert them when the Northern Lights is being shown. And apparently they had a false alarm because of a lawnmower. So someone mowing their lawn caused everybody to hustle to look at the sky. And it was not there. This was interesting. I was surprised you didn't get this one on your links, Phoenix. I thought you would have had this one.
Good, Phoenix.
Dropbox is forcing you to change your password if they notice you have not changed your password since 2012, which 4 years later, you should have changed your password.
Yeah, you know what? And it's probably not even Dropbox. It's probably the people who hacked into Dropbox's email server and they're hacked into.
Yeah, they did it in 2013 and just leaked it today.
And they're just like, "Oh, hey, change your passwords because we're watching you."
They're like, "Come on."
Yeah, I would never change my password if someone told me to. I would wait till no one was watching, kind of thing.
They need updated passwords, so that's why they're getting everybody to change so they can monitor the new passwords.
Yeah, right.
Nick, I thought you would find this one interesting, even though you already had your fancy little gizmo there. But apparently this one, I feel like this one might do better, even though it's a little bit more awkward. Yeah,
way more awkward.
Yeah,
what in the heck? That's just a tube that sits around the thing, dude. What are you talking about, my fancy gizmo? The hell is that? What are you talking about? What is so wrong with this thing? It's just a simple bang nail clipper. I mean, we talked about it's not fancy. It just has like a thing here, and it doesn't. That's not fancy. It just catches your clipping.
A simple one doesn't have that. A fancy one.
A simple one has like a hole in the side where they fall out.
Yeah.
But yeah. You just have to close up the sides, though. You're right. The fix that you posted is cheaper than that. And you just close the sides, though. I mean, it's really.
Well, this is the only only drawback to this one is it doesn't have the it has this little flip over thing that you got to flip over to make the thing, but it doesn't have the hook guy. So I keep a regular round for the hook thing.
I was going to ask you, because I've had fingernail clippings that don't just go straight back, that they like fly off to the side or...
Well, no, this one, it like catches everything. It because it, I mean, they fly off to the side because there's nothing on the side. I mean, it catches everything.
I mean, like it flies backwards or...
I've had like maybe in the 8 months that I've had that, I've had like 2 clippings fly out in the front or something. But if I do more than one hand or foot at a time, if I do more than like 5 or so at a time, I'm invariably going to tilt it in such a way that they're going to fall out the front anyway or something. So I have to like stop and empty it like every 5 digits or... Or I'm just going to screw it up. And it's me. It's not the thing. It's me. But I will screw it up somehow. So.
Well, if you take that one you have and then also use the capsule tube, you'll be fully protected. And you can do
well, I think I could screw that up too. Like when you're switching hands. That's usually why it happens after 5 digits.
And I can see that happening too. So yesterday was a 100th anniversary of the national parks, and we posted a couple links on the national parks. I do have a couple more. I wanted to point out this one specifically because I was looking through it and I was like, man, I wonder if I visited any of these. And lo and behold, the one in Colorado is probably my second favorite national park. Black Canyon of Gunnison is amazing. If you are anywhere in the vicinity of that and able to travel there, it's in southwest Colorado. Honestly, we camped in the Gunnison National Forest there, and that was probably some of the cleanest air I've ever breathed in my life. And this canyon, I felt, was more spectacular and stunning than I was with the Grand Canyon. And I understand the Grand Canyon is a lot better. It's a lot bigger. It's just, it's so massive that you can't really grasp what you're looking at when you see it. Like even looking at pictures, you're just kind of like, wow, that's pretty cool. But this one, the difference is the canyon just goes straight down, like just straight down. It is insane. That one. Let's see if I actually can pull up some pictures of it, because I did have some on.
Listen, you guys have a great weekend. I gotta go.
Okay, later.
But take care.
Bye. Have fun storming the castle.
That park is super cool, and actually, it pointed out that page pointed out another really interesting national park that's in South Carolina here, which I was going to see if Johnny and I could go to. It's about 2.5 hours away from us, but
you didn't mention it before now. It's, by the way, Johnny, sorry.
Yeah, no, I hadn't mentioned it yet, so I was going to ask her right now.
Which park, Brantley?
Right now on the show where you feel pressured to say yes.
the one on that page for South Carolina, it's right below Columbia, South Carolina. It's a swamp, first off. So, I mean, obviously, that's probably one of the reasons why it isn't a most visited.
And why she's going to say no unless it's really on the air.
But it has a what I thought was interesting is it has a 2.4-mile boardwalk that you can walk through the swamp and see. It actually has some of the oldest hardwoods in North America in that swamp. Oh, that was pretty cool. I think if I remember correctly on that link that I posted there, the first one I believe was in Arizona. What was it, Arizona? There is one that has the oldest hardwoods in the entire world. Actually the oldest living organisms at 5,000 years old. And it was blocked off just to save that particular piece of land and such. So I thought that was a really cool one too. But yeah, check out all of those on there and go check those out, because they are it's not the Petrified Forest. It's actually a different one, and these are still alive. The Petrified Forest, those are actually dead. But it's called the Hardwood Forest of the East. So I want to say it was somewhere on the East Coast, but I'm not looking at the article yet. I'm looking for that awesome Black Canyon photo that I had taken. But yeah, check out that article. Go check out those parks, because honestly, those are some of your best parks to visit, the ones that are least visited, because there's not going to be a whole bunch of people in the way. When we went to Black Canyon and Gunnison, I think we saw maybe 10 other people versus going to Grand Canyon. We saw 10 people every 5 minutes. So huge, huge difference in being able to observe and watch nature and appreciate it, I feel.
The Spartan race we're doing is in Winnsboro, South Carolina, and we're gonna camp in the Sumter National Forest.
Oh, cool. How far away is that from Columbia?
Looks like a pretty far way.
So this is a link where I almost fell off a cliff, but it's probably one of the favorite photos I've been able to take in Colorado. And then this is a link of the canyon by itself, just looking at the river. And this is a place of where we camped. And again, by far the cleanest air that I've ever breathed has been at that place.
You can pilot takes forever. Mm.
Your compiler takes forever?
Decompiler.
Oh.
Object testing.
Oh, yeah. Where was the Hardwoods of the East?
Now I'm tired. Thank you.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right.
Do you know you're wearing so Arizona.
Livening up the Friday.
It's because you have too many hats on. It's making your head tired.
I do wear too many hats in this biz.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Yeah! I have to cut that one.
Might need to turn your mic volume down a little there.
Okay. Perhaps.
So Arizona looks like you have the Oregon Pipe Cactus National Park. That looks pretty interesting. It was the Columbia, South Carolina one. That's the they call that the Hardwood of the East. And 41 meter tall elm, 38 meter laurel oak. And is that the one that had the 5,000?
How about now?
That's better.
Yay.
I can't figure out what had that 5,000 now, so oh well. Anyway, I thought that was pretty cool, and definitely go check those out. If you want to see all of the national parks ranked, I do have this as well. And definitely do not complain about not having Wi-Fi if you're at a national park, as this article tells you. So, cool there, and we are well past our hour. Did anyone else have anything they wanted to specifically talk about?
Nothing
or mention?
At all. Need to watch this portal video that Beavis posted a while back so I can see, you have my axe! And then I'm going to go play with Wi.
Cool. Well, I will leave everyone with something to terrify their dreams over the weekend. Apparently, they are building a robot to exterminate lionfish because it's a invasive species. But come on, making robots to kill things doesn't sound like a good idea. So,
but what are they also they good for?
Vote nay on that. What, lionfish or robots to kill things? or robots in general?
Robots and robots, for one thing.
Robot. But
that's another topic.
That's how Michael says it. Yeah.
Robot.
All right. Well, let's wrap her up for today. Phoenix posted one extra link there. Opera Sync servers have been hacked. Login names, emails, and passwords have been stolen. So if you've been using Opera, which they are, aren't they like 1% of the market?
That's still a large part of it.
It is still a lot of people, yeah. But still.
Yeah.
Comparatively. Yeah. And yeah, they should have their sync servers a little bit more secure. Yeah,
well, they all should have quit that years ago anyway.
Anyway, so let's go ahead and wrap her up for today. Thanks everyone for joining us. We will be back Monday morning at 8 a.m. And we're going to try something a little different next week.
We'll be sober.
Normally all of us are.
On Mondays, anyway.
We're going to try doing a focused piece. So back to the early days of the Foolish Tech Show where we had a whole segment on one particular item. I had signed Michael this Monday, but I'm sure he's going to bail out, so I'll probably have something interesting planned as backup for
you. Please do, because, yeah.
Thanks everyone for joining us. We'll be back on Monday at 8 a.m. Definitely, if you do have any questions or things you want to go over with our software, that's what we're mainly here for, but hopefully you get some other entertainment or interesting things out of it as well in the meantime.
Yeah, because otherwise we'll entertain ourselves.
That's what we're doing, honestly, but hopefully it entertains others. So thanks everyone. We will see you on Monday. Take us on out, Proctor.
All right, have a good weekend.